Welcome back, guys. Before we move on to the next part of this tutorial, there are a few changes I would want us to make on the footer. The first change is that I want to add the height of the text area, and then secondly, I want to increase the font size of the text on this send button. So let's start with the text area. We go back to our source code and open our index.html file. Now, on the text area element, we are going to add a rows property and give it a value of 4. And then the next thing now is our contact button. And we had already selected this in our CSS. So we are just going to add here the font size to be like 10% larger. And then we'll give it a font family of Lora. And Lora is the font family we had added at the start of this series. So having made these changes, we go back to our browser and refresh, and it looks better now. Now let's move on to what we intend to do in this tutorial. In this episode, we are going to be designing the single blog post page, which is going to look something like what we see here in the finished project. It has the main content section, which displays the post in detail. And to my right here, we have a sidebar, and the sidebar is just slightly different from what we had in the index page. Different in that here we are embedding a Facebook page where a user can like your Facebook page while still on your blog. And then we have the popular post section where they can browse some of your popular posts on your website. And the topic section, which we had in the index page, remains here also. So that's it. Let's open our text editor and start coding. So we are going to create a file in the root folder of our application called single.html. And to write the markup for this file, we are just going to come to the index.html page. We select everything and we copy. And then we paste it inside our single.html page. Now we can scroll to the top and start making modifications. The first thing is that the title of this page is going to read single post. And then we'll continue to scroll down. The navigation bar is going to remain here. We're not going to change it. And then the page wrapper wraps all the contents on our page, so it will remain the same for the single.html page. But in this case, in the single post page, we are not going to need a post slider. We are not going to need the carousel, so I'm going to start selecting where the comment marks the beginning of the post slider. I'll scroll down and select. Scroll down and select until I meet the ending comment, the comment that marks the end of the post slider, which is right here. So having selected the post slider, I'm just going to take it out. I'm going to get rid of the comments as well. Okay, so now what we have is our content, which we are going to leave it here. And then we have the main contents, and the main content here displays the actual post itself, not the recent post as was the case in the index.html page. So we are going to select everything inside the main content. We scroll down and select until we meet the ending comment marking the end of the main content section. So having selected this, we are going to take it out. And remember, we did not take out the opening and the closing elements for the main content section. So this is how the page is structured. We have the content that is enclosing the main content and the sidebar. Let me just add a few comments on the sidebar so that we can see where it starts and where it ends. So this is where it starts and it ends right here. Okay, so on our sidebar, what modifications are we going to make? The first thing is that we are not going to need the search input on our sidebar. So I'm just going to take that out. And we are left with the sidebar and the main contents inside our content section. Let's just add a heading here. The title of our post. We are just going to give it a class of post title. Okay, so having made these modifications, the rest of the page remains the same, the footer remains the same. So having made these modifications, we can head over to our browser again, and we go to the single.html page, and it looks good enough. We have the sidebar here and we have the main content. Now the background of the main content is supposed to be white. So let's open our code, and notice that on the single page, the background of the main content is going to be white, whereas on the index.html page, the background of the main content is not actually white. So there is a bit of a difference between the index, the main content on the index page and that on the single page. So what we are going to do is we are going to add a class on the main contents of our single page called single. So this will enable us to differentiate between the styling for the main content of the index page and that for the single page. So we'll go to our CSS file and we scroll to the content, the styling for the content section. Okay, so this is it. And we are going to look for the styling for the main content. We select the main content of the single page. And remember, because the main content and the single class are on the same element, there is no space between the dots separating them. So what we want to do is give this main content on the single page a background color of white. We give it a padding of 20 pixels at the top and 50 pixels on the sides. And we are going to make the font size slightly larger. And with that, that's all. We can go back to our web page and refresh. And we see that the background indeed is white. But one thing I don't like here is because is this the topics. The topic section has a background of white, and that white is directly merging with the main content section in a way that we cannot see the difference between them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give the sidebar a padding of about 10 pixels so that we can see the difference between the two sections. So I'm going to scroll down again to where I wrote the styling for the sidebar. I come back to the single page and I'm going to add another class called single to the sidebar. And then back in the CSS, I'm going to select this property. I'm going to select it for the single page. And what I will do is I'll give it a padding at the top of 0 pixels and on the sides of about 10 pixels. So having done that, we go back to our browser and refresh, and you will notice now that there is a clear difference between the sidebar and the main content. One thing I'll want to do also is to provide some round borders on the main content. So when we do this and go back, we'll notice that the borders are also a bit rounded. The edges are also a bit rounded. Now let's add some content on our index, on our main content. We'll go back to the single.html page. And just after the title, this is where the post content itself, the text of our post is going to be displayed, and it's going to be displayed in a series of paragraphs. So let's just write something like that. Let's give some 15 random words. Then we add another paragraph of say 30 random words. Then we add another, let's say 40. We do this one more time, and let's say 10 words. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy these paragraphs and duplicate instead of having to type them one after the other. And having done this, I will save, and then we'll go back to our browser and refresh. Okay, now this is our post. One last thing we need to do on the main content section is to centralize our post title and give some space between the title and the text itself. So let's go to our CSS. Remember, we gave our post title a title of post title, a class of post title, and now we are going to select it. And we'll give it a, we'll align it in the center. And then we'll give it a margin at the bottom of about 40 pixels. When we do that, we can refresh now, and it's centralized. So the next thing we need to do now is to add a popular post section on our sidebar. So let's go back to our code, the single.html page. We scroll down to the sidebar section just above the topic section, and we are just going to add another section for popular posts. I'm just going to give it a class of popular, and then inside here we'll give it a title of popular posts. Or can just call it popular if you like. And each of the posts here is going to be pretty simple. I'm just going to create an element of with class post, and inside that element we'll have an image which will come from the images folder, and we'll have the title. We are just going to give a simple title like how to overcome your fears, and we're just going to give this a class of title. Okay, so this is it. I'm just going to copy this a couple of times. I'm just going to copy this, and then I paste it a couple of times. Okay, so and that's it. Let's go back to our browser. You haven't written the style, so I'm guessing that this will look awful, and surely enough it looks quite scattered, and that's because we have not provided dimensions to our images. So let's go back to our code, and the first thing is that each of the classes we are going to float the image to the left, and we'll float the title to the right. And when we do that, we are going to make our element, these two elements, out of the normal document flow. So in order to solve that, we are going to add a class of clearfix to the parent element. Okay, so having added this, we can go now and write the styling for our post element. So we scroll down here, and we are going to create another section for popular posts. I'm just going to say popular. Remember, we gave that element a class of popular, and we select each of the posts Give it a border at the top of 1 pixel solid gray. We give it a margin at the top of about 10 pixels, a padding at the top of, let's say, 10 pixels. Now let's select the image inside that post. We'll just select the image tag. We'll give it a width and height of 60 pixels. We float it to the left. And we give it a margin to the right of about 10 pixels so that there is some space between the image element and the title. So having done this, we can even go to our browser and refresh. And there is a problem. Our styling is not taking effect, and that is because we are writing contents instead of content. So we get rid of the S, we save, and when we refresh again, this time our browser, our popular posts are being listed. So I'm going to add the width of this element just a bit because it looks stretched vertically. So for the width, I'm going to make it 75. And when we refresh, it looks now like an actual post. So we can even add the size of this title. I'm going to come here and I'll place an H, let me say an H4 element inside each of the titles. And we refresh. Okay, it looks better. And we can do the same for all the other elements. So I'm just going to select each of the titles and paste. So when we refresh, our popular post section looks good now. So we can call this the end of this section. In the coming sections, I'm going to show you how to embed your Facebook page on the sidebar like we did here. So thank you guys for watching. Please like, subscribe, share, and hopefully I will see you in the next video.